Immunotherapy is a type of treatment that prompts a patient's own immune system to fight cancer. In this excerpt from the documentary film, Cancer, the Emperor of All Maladies, Dr. Stephen A. Rosenberg, head of surgery at the National Cancer Institute's Center for Cancer Research, describes his pioneering work in this promising field. He begins by recalling an inspirational encounter early in his career with a patient whose cancer had disappeared without treatment.
All aspects of his cancer were gone. He had undergone one of the most rare events in all of medicine. He had had a spontaneous regression of all of his metastatic cancer.
Rosenberg believed that the explanation had to lie in the patient's own immune system. He decided then and there to focus his research on immune cells or lymphocytes.
Okay, let's talk about admissions for this week.
The body has hundreds of billions of lymphocytes. And somewhere in the body of a cancer patient, there are lymphocytes, we hypothesize, that could recognize what was different about the cancer.
So Mark, let's hear about cells.
We have Cermak on the NMA arm of the randomized protocol. The students start confusion.
It was that hypothesis, it was that dream that then led us to try to identify the actual cells that were attacking the cancer and use them to actually develop a cancer treatment.
Rosenberg isolated various types of immune cells in his lab, and in a series of clinical trials, injected them into patients. But progress was painfully slow. In the first 66 patients, his therapy showed no signs of working. Then, in 1984, he treated the 67th, a Navy officer named Linda Taylor, with a far higher dose. 3 decades later, she is still in perfect health.
Oh. I tell you, I never cry except around you.
It was an important event in the development of cancer treatments because it showed people that it was possible, at that point in a very tiny percentage of patients, to cause the immune system to make a cancer disappear.
The hope from those early experiments was that if you could somehow activate specific aspects of the immune system, could you now educate it to attack a cancer cell and not attack a normal cell?
Rosenberg went on to discover that a specific type of immune cell, called a T cell, was active against some cancers, but when greatly outnumbered, was too weak to defeat them. Through dozens of experimental trials, he learned to extract these cancer-fighting T cells from a patient's own body, grow them in the lab into a vast army, billions of cells strong, and then infuse them back into the patient's body to fight his or her cancer.
So in our last 6 evaluable patients, there are 4 complete regressions and 2 partial regressions. So
we're in the beginnings of a very long and hopefully exciting road with immunological therapies. There are people who've dedicated their lives to this. And finally, we're beginning to see interesting glimmers in which the immune system can be educated to start to see cancers and to kill those cancers.